Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you how you can automate the PGP file decryption process for any files uploaded to Amazon S3 or Amazon EFS via the AWS Transfer Family Service using the Managed Workflow feature. For the purpose of this video, I will assume that everyone is already familiar with what the Transfer Family Service is, as well as what Transfer Family Managed Workflows are. If you are unfamiliar with either of these topics, please refer to the video that is linked in the description below, as it provides a great summary regarding what the Transfer Family Service is, as well as what Transfer Family Managed Workflows are. Quick overview of what I'll be covering today in this video. I'll start by going over a short refresher of what PGP is and its typical use cases. I'll walk through each step of the managed workflow and explain how the PGP Decryption Lambda function works. I'll go over the custom Transfer Family identity provider that I'll be implementing in this video and explain why you may want to use this over traditional Transfer Family Managed users. I will then explain how all these different pieces fit together using an architecture diagram. And I'll finish out the video by showing you how to configure this solution within your own AWS environment, as well as provide a quick demonstration of what the managed workflow looks like in action. For those of you who may be unfamiliar with PGP, it stands for Pretty Good Privacy, and it's an encryption system used for sending encrypted emails and encrypting files. PGP is mainly used today to help organizations meet various security compliance requirements and to ensure that only the intended parties have access to specific files. The main challenge, however, is that PGP encryption and decryption add a layer of operational complexity. Today, I'll show you how you can remove this undifferentiated heavy lifting by automating the PGP decryption process using a Transfer Family Managed Workflow. So the Managed Workflow contains four steps in total, one of which will manage the PGP decryption process. The first step is to copy any file that is uploaded to S3 via the Transfer Family to an S3 prefix named archive. The next step then tags the file that was copied to the archive prefix as archived. Then, the workflow orchestrator invokes the custom Lambda function, which performs the actual PGP decryption process, and the Lambda function then moves the decrypted file to an S3 prefix named decrypted files. Lastly, the originally uploaded file gets deleted from S3 since it was archived in step 1 and decrypted and moved to the decrypted files prefix in step 3. If any errors occur during a workflow's execution, the exception handling steps that you specify are executed. Several things can cause these exception handling steps to be invoked, such as if the file decryption process fails for any reason, if the timeout threshold for a step is reached, or if a step fails for other reasons, such as inadequate S3 permissions on a copy step. Regardless of the reason which causes the workflow to fail, the exception handling steps for this workflow will copy the file that it failed to an S3 prefix named failed decryption, tag the file with the status of failed decryption, and then delete the originally uploaded file. The way the custom PGP decryption Lambda function works is by first, it downloads the newly uploaded file from S3, it then checks if the file is encrypted or not. If the file is encrypted, the Lambda function pulls the private key required for decryption from Secrets Manager and performs the decryption. Once the file has been decrypted, it is moved to the S3 prefix named Decrypted Files, and a success message is sent back to the Managed Workflow using the Send Workflow Step State API. Once the workflow receives this success message, it continues with the next step of the workflow. If the file decryption process fails for any reason, the Lambda function reports this failure back to the Managed Workflow, and the exception handling steps are invoked. In this demo, I will use a custom Secrets Manager-based identity provider for Transfer Family user authentication. However, please note that this custom identity provider is optional, as the PGP Decryption Lambda function will work the same regardless of how you choose to authenticate users. The reason I'm using this custom identity provider is because it provides several extra features that Transfer Family Managed users do not currently support, such as username and password authentication and source IP address checks. Now that you're familiar with each step of the process, let's put it all together with this architecture diagram. First, the user sends an authentication request to the Transfer Family Server endpoint, which is then forwarded to the custom Lambda function identity provider. The Lambda function will then check if the authentication credentials provided match what is stored within Secrets Manager, for example, a username and password. If these credentials do match, then the user is authenticated to the Transfer Family Server. Step 4 is where the main part of the project actually begins, when a user uploads a file to S3 via the Transfer Family. Once the file is uploaded, the Transfer Family Managed Workflow gets invoked, and it goes through the four steps that I discussed earlier in this video. For the purpose of this video, I'll be going through this configuration process rather quickly. For detailed step-by-step instructions on how to recreate this project, please refer to the README file on the AWS Samples GitHub repository for this project, which is linked in the video description below. So the first step of the project is to clone the GitHub repository into our Cloud Shell environment. After that, we'll change into the new directory and give the setup environment bash script executable permissions. Then we'll run the setup environment bash script. So right now, this bash script is downloading the package and binary file, which are required to make the custom PGP decryption Lambda function work. After it downloads all the required files, it will zip them up and push them to AWS as a Lambda layer. If you're not familiar with what Lambda layers are, they're used to provide a convenient way to package libraries and other dependencies that you can use with your Lambda functions. Now that the script has finished building my Lambda layer, I'm going to deploy the first CloudFormation stack by copying this command from the README and pasting it into Cloud Shell. First, give the stack a name. I'm going to name mine PGP Decryption Stack. Then, select a region. I'm just going to press Enter for this one to leave it as default. Now, enter a name for the S3 bucket that this stack is going to create. I'm going to name mine PGP Decrypted Files. Then, respond to the rest of the prompts. For a full list of all my responses to these stack creation parameters, refer to the README file on the GitHub repository. Right now, this stack is creating the required IAM roles, S3 bucket, Lambda function, PGP private key secret, and managed workflow. Now I'm going to deploy the second CloudFormation stack, which will create a transfer family server with the custom identity provider I mentioned earlier in this video. First, I'll create a new directory named temp and change into it. Now I'm going to grab the link to download the CloudFormation stack and paste it into Cloud Shell. Now I'll unzip the folder containing all the files I need to deploy, and then I'll run the command sam deploy guided. Now I'll give the stack a name. I'm going to name mine transfer family server, but you can name yours whatever you'd like. After that, accept all the options as default simply by pressing enter. Same as with the last stack deployment, refer to the GitHub README file for a full list of my responses to these stack creation parameters. Now that we've ran the setup environment bash script and deployed both CloudFormation stacks, I'm going to create a new transfer family user for the custom identity provider. So I'll navigate to the Secrets Manager console and select Store a New Secret. Then I'll select Other Type of Secret, and I'll create four different key value pairs for password, role, home directory details, and home directory type. Please note that the secret key names are case sensitive, so be sure to name the keys exactly the same as I do. To get the value for the role field, I'll navigate to the CloudFormation console and select Stacks. Then I'll select the name of the first stack we deployed. Then I'll select Outputs. Now I'll copy the IAM roles ARN, navigate back into Secrets Manager, and paste that into the value field for my role. Now for the home directory details field, I'll navigate to the README file, copy the secret value from the table, and paste it into Secrets Manager. Now I'll switch back to CloudFormation once more to grab the name of the S3 bucket that I created. I'll copy the name, and I'll replace the part of the secret that says insert S3 bucket name with the name of my S3 bucket. Then I'll change to where it says insert username, and insert whatever I want the username to be. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to name my user test user. Lastly, for the home directory details field, I'm going to paste in the word logical in all caps for the secret value. The reason I'm doing this is to create a logical directory for my transfer family user. This logical directory can be used to set the user's root directory to a desired location within my storage hierarchy. By implementing a logical directory structure, I can avoid disclosing absolute paths and S3 bucket names to any end users. If you'd like to learn more about logical directories with transfer family users, please refer to the link in the description below. Now I'll click Next, and I'll give my secret a name. For this custom identity provider, the secret must be stored in the format of server ID / username. To get the transfer family server ID, I'll go to the CloudFormation console, select the name of the transfer family server stack, and then select Outputs. I'll copy the server ID and paste it into the secret's name field. Then I'll add a backslash, followed by whatever I assigned as the username. So in my case, I will enter test user. All right, now I'll press next, leave all the options as default, press next again, and then press store. Now that I've got my user configured, I need to paste in my PGP private key into the secret that was created by the CloudFormation stack I deployed earlier in this video. So I'm gonna open up my PGP private key, copy it, go back into Secrets Manager, replace the text that is serving as a placeholder, and paste in my private key, and select save. The last step I need to complete is to attach my newly created transfer family managed workflow to my transfer family server. To do this, in the transfer family console, I'll select the server, then select edit, then scroll down to where it says managed workflows, and I'll select the newly created workflow. For the managed workflow execution role, I will select the role that's named PGP Decryption Managed Workflow Role. I'll then scroll down to the bottom and select Save. Now that I've finished the configuration process, let's see how the managed workflow looks in action. To start off, I'm going to open up a PGP encrypted file stored locally on my machine. As we can see, the file is indeed encrypted, and no useful information can be gained from this file. Now I'm going to connect to my transfer family server. So first, I'm going to copy the endpoint ID from the transfer family console. Then I'm going to open up my file transfer client. I'll be using WinSCP, but you can use any file transfer client that you would like. The process will work the exact same. So now that we've got WinSCP open, I'm going to paste in the endpoint ID. The method for authentication will vary based on how you deployed your transfer family server. Since I deployed the transfer family server with a custom identity provider, I'll be using a username and password to authenticate. Now that I've successfully connected to my transfer family server, I'll upload the encrypted document that I opened earlier, as well as some other test documents. Now that these files have been uploaded, let's go into the S3 bucket to see how the managed workflow has handled these files. Right off the bat, I can see the three different prefixes. Let's look at the archive prefix first. Once I click into this prefix, I see another prefix that is named after the username. This is done in order to sort files that are uploaded by different users. Once I click into this prefix, I can see all the files that I uploaded have indeed been archived. Now I'm going to navigate into the decrypted files prefix. And again, we see the username prefix. Once we click into that, we can see the file that was initially encrypted has been decrypted. Now I'm going to go ahead and download this file and open it. And as you can see, the file has indeed been successfully decrypted. Lastly, I'll look at the failed decryption prefix, where I can see two files that I uploaded that are purposely intended to fail the decryption process. The first file was encrypted with a different key pair than what I have stored in Secrets Manager. The other file was actually never encrypted. It was just a .txt file that I renamed to .gpg. Since both these files are unable to be decrypted, we see them here in the failed decryption prefix. Now I'm going to quickly walk through what the CloudWatch logs look like for this process. To access these logs, within CloudWatch, select Log Groups, then select the specific transfer family server, and then the specific workflow. So we can see that the workflow execution started, then it copied the file to archive. After that, it tagged the file for archive. Then it invoked the custom PGP decryption Lambda function. And lastly, it deleted the original file. Now I'm going to quickly shift over to a different log to show what the exception handling steps look like. As soon as the workflow orchestrator receives notification that a step in the workflow has failed, it executes the exception handling steps, as we can see here. That completes today's video. To recap, today we went over a specific transfer family managed workflow to automate the PGP decryption process. We walked through the process of how to configure this within your own AWS environment, and finished up by providing a demo of what the workflow looks like in action. Thank you all for watching. I hope you have a great day.